This video was sponsored by Envato Elements. Get your free trial from the video description. In this video, I'm going to show you how to convert any flat illustration into 3D using Photoshop. I will start by explaining the main concept. Then with a free action, you'll be able to convert any shape to 3D with a few clicks. Also, you can create isometric worlds like this one by just using our free action. Now let's jump into Photoshop and get started. I'll start by creating a new document. Set width to 1500 pixels, height to 1000, with RGB 8-bit color mode, then click Create. You don't have to follow this part, just watch it to understand how I did it. Let's first import the isometric grid to understand what we're going to do. You can get these files download links from the video description below. I made this isometric grid to help you draw any isometric shape by just following the grid lines like that. So these grid lines will help us make the perfect isometric 3D icons. Now let's import the shape that will be converted to 3D. I'll start by importing this simple icon. Right here, we can make three main depth directions: back, right, and left. If I want to extrude it in the right direction, I'll need to free transform our layer first with Ctrl and T. Then right click and choose Skew. And from that middle point, drag it to the bottom until it matches the isometric grid like that. The angle here should be near 30 degrees. And also, these four transform lines should be parallel to the grid lines just like that. Press Enter to submit once everything is alright. Now I will double click the layer to change its color from here. Pick any color you want, then click OK. Right click and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now after having the right isometric angle, let's add a 3D depth. I will simply hold the Alt key and drag the layer to the bottom until I see these two arrows, then release it to duplicate it there. After that, I'll press the top and right arrow keys so that I can move the layer one pixel in both directions. I'll keep duplicating and moving them using the arrow keys until I have around 10 layers. Once I finish, I'll get this 3D depth. But as you can see, it is totally flat. And to fix that, I will double-click any layer to add a bevel and emboss to it. First, I'll change the depth to 500% with any size, zero soften, and any angle. The most important thing here is to make sure that Use Global Light option is checked. I'm going to leave both shadows and highlights as they are, but I'll decrease their opacities a little bit to around 40%. And that's it. I can now right-click the layer and copy its layer style. Then I'll select all layers while holding the Shift key and right-click to paste layer style to all of them. Great! And this should distribute the bevel shadows and highlights all over the 3D depth. Let's double-click any layer style right here to explain something. Right here, if I change the shading angle of the current layer, all other layers will get the same exact new angle. And as a result, this will change the entire lighting of the 3D depth. And this is happening because all layers are now connected with a global light. I like the shading at this point, so I'm going to click OK to submit. Finally, let's select all layers while holding the Shift key. Then convert all of them to a smart object. Hide both smart object and grid layer. And now let's move on to the next step so that we can do all that with a single click. But before moving to the next step, let's hear from our today's sponsor. Envato Elements is an unlimited subscription website that gives you unlimited downloads of millions of high-quality digital assets. You'll find everything you're looking for, starting from stock photos, video templates, mockups, audio files, fonts, Photoshop actions, and much, much more. If you type Photoshop action in the search bar, you will get more than 8,000 results of premium actions. You can use any of them to achieve your exclusive designs with just a few clicks. They offer a 50% discount on annual subscription, so it will only cost you $16.50 instead of $33 per month. Just click the link in the description to get your 7-day free trial of unlimited downloads. Now, let's get back to our tutorial. First, let's open the Actions panel from here. From this little icon, click on Load Actions. You can download this action for free from the description below. This free action offers three depth directions: top right, top back, and flat right. But if you want more directions, you can download the full premium action from our Patreon page. You can join us there and get unlimited access to all our YouTube projects. As you can see, each direction has a separate action to add extra 3D depth to it. Also, there are some extra actions to decrease the 3D depth and also change the 3D lighting. And finally, there is an action to finalize the final result. Let's now have our first example. I will start with this house icon. Then I will make sure that my layer is selected. After that, I will choose one of these three actions. Let's try the top right direction one. And with my layer selected, I will click on this little run icon. Without clicking anywhere, let's increase the 3D depth by running the action below it. Click to increase the depth as much as you want. If there is so much depth, I can use this action to decrease the depth again. But please note, if I collapse the depth group and try to run the decrease depth action, the entire depth will be removed like that. And this brings us to an important note. While running the action, don't touch the layers panel until you finish. Let's test that lighting action. Just change the lighting direction from here. Once you're satisfied with the result, click OK. Finally, select the last action and run it to convert your final result to a smart object. And here is our final 3D isometric icon. Let's create a 3D ground for this house. I want to make a circular ground, so I'm going to use this ellipse tool. Change this color to anything you like. I'll pick this light gray color. Also, make sure that it doesn't have any stroke around it from here. And now let's run the action. This time, I will use the flat right direction action, which can be used to create 3D horizontal shapes. After selecting the action, select your layer and click Run. This will convert the circle to a flat isometric 3D shape like that. I think the depth is all right, but I only need to change the 3D lighting by running this action. Keep moving the angle from here, and once you're good to go, just click OK. Finally, let's run the smart object action to finish this up. Drag it below the house shape and align it as you want. And that's it. You may want to convert an icon from an Illustrator file. For example, let's open this car's Illustrator file. Let's say I want to convert this car to a 3D shape. First, I'll pick this lasso tool, then select what I want to remove. Then press delete to remove it. And after that, select the entire car to copy it with Ctrl and C. Get back to Photoshop and press Ctrl and V to paste it there. Choose pixels and click OK. This copy and paste feature should work between all Adobe CC versions. Now let's press Ctrl and T, then right click to flip the car horizontally. Make sure to select your action. Select your layer, then click Run. Let's increase the 3D depth. Also change the lighting. Play with the angle until you have a good result. And finally, convert the final result to a smart object. You can press Ctrl and T to resize it, then place it as you want. And here is how it will look without the horizontal flip. Now let's add some decorative trees. Just open their Illustrator file first. And with the lasso tool, select what you want to delete and remove it with the delete key. Then select the tree itself and press Ctrl and C to copy it. Open Photoshop and paste it there with Ctrl and V. Click OK and place it where you want. And with this layer selected, I'll try this top back direction action. I think I don't need any modifications right here, so I'm going to run the last action to finish this up. Resize it and duplicate it if you want. Finally, let's unhide the location pin that we created before. Place it over the house and resize it like that. And that's how you can create your own isometric scene from flat shapes and icons. If you need any help, please leave your comment below. And don't forget to check out this tutorial to learn how to vectorize any image using Photoshop and export the final result to Illustrator with a click. Thanks for watching, and see you next time!